And hello everyone. Happy Memorial Day. Oh, bunker theories. Oh. Gonna be messing around on GTA. As why the hell not? Memorial Day? I mean, you ain't got shit to do. Just that simple. Yeah, no, I got some really weird names for a lot of the outfits I have. Another crap car.
Are available now at the casino store.
Chips or cash?
Is your wallet safe?
Yes, it's in my pocket.
Sorry if I sound like I'm a little sniffly. I don't want to get copyright claimed. Ooh, this is battle. do some of this grinding in peace. It's all good. Fuck. You gotta be kidding me. Fuck. That took a bit. You know, I've had just about enough of these guys. So even when doing business battles, sometimes you just leave it alone. Somebody else wants it. I'm just basically gonna be the polite guy and just say, you know what, you have it. You go ahead and have it. But sometimes I think the one guy who just got confused is like, wait, you just leaving? It's right here in the open. Why? And he's just leaving it. That should give you a clue. Okay, yeah, you want it. You clearly want it. Okay, yeah, I'll let you have it. Plus, I already got a lot of money anyway, so I can let this one slide. And this is all due to grinding, not glitching like most people would do. Because, you know, if you're gonna glitch money, it just shows you really have no time. You really don't have a lot of time, and you really just like. Well, it really kind of just shows that you suck at the game, really. What's the point of playing a game if you're not gonna try and earn the money? But then again, if you're gonna help out someone else, like I know there was a person that sent me an invite for their CEO. But what's the point of like having help if you're just gonna do all the work yourself? Just there's no point. You're just basically dead weight. And that's the one thing you don't want to feel like when you're basically playing in like a team-based game is when you're just feeling like you're dead weight. Even though you're trying your hardest, but again, the guy just doing everything, and why the heck do you just need me anyway if you could just do all that yourself? Because most of the time, when I'm doing these things, I'm just doing it by myself. It can be a little bit tougher. Hell, the extra help always is nice, especially during these business battles. The worser ones is obviously the people who just, like, you know, who think it's just way too far, and they always have all their, like, businesses and stuff out of the way of the city. I'd say, personally, it's a lot better to have them all closer to the city so you actually can have easier access to get them back. Like with the ones with the scrapyard and the one with the aircraft carrier. Even in lobbies like this, some people are just going, everyone's just running around like chickens with their heads cut off sometimes. You don't really know what they're doing, or, well, again, they're just doing their own thing. But in all the bigger lobbies, yeah, just running around, and some of these people, especially those who grief, they wonder why they're broke in the game. But they do have, like, very valuable things, usually just having an oppressor, and that's about it. And that's what they use that tool for, just to grieve. I use my oppressor to grind and make money in this game. You grind to grieve other players because you have no money. We are not the same. But I'm gonna say I'm not guilty in like going around griefing other players. I've actually done it in an insurgent pickup before, going on a full-on rampage to a server with a friend or two. But again, when you're doing that, it's fun for a little bit, but eventually it wears off. So especially when people are going around griefing me, I just let it happen because, again, in terms of everything in this game, your KD doesn't mean shit. Even then, it's just like, I've told players this, but even one of them just simply replied, "Oh yeah, it may not to you, but it matters to me." Yeah, and again, I told him, "Yeah, you're deluded if you believe that." Yeah, because it seems like there are always people who always think their stats mean everything. Yeah, like it's life or death. Yeah, if you believe all that kind of shit, guess what? It just shows that outside of playing a video game, your life isn't really all that really your life isn't really all spectacular. And this is just a way for you to really kind of just cope with it. But when you're a teenager, yeah, if you're a teenager going through that, yeah, it's a good way to help with a bit of a coping mechanism if you're dealing with all the stresses of that. But as an adult, it's just fun, it's just simple relaxation, just downtime from the stresses of life. And it's kind of sad, though, because I know younger generations are just, like, again, not really, still not knowing what they want to do in life. It's even worse if they do. It's even worse if they just can't still find it, even when they're older, when they're getting older. Oh. I guess that guy should thank me for that. I think I'll just sell it. Again, these low-level lobbies are for people who just don't want to deal with the annoyance of other players.
Good news, the buyer has thrown in a cash bonus. Bad news, you gotta get the shipment to them looking pristine. No scrapes, no scratches, no head-on collisions. Drive.
Also, another thing that's also pretty fun in this game now, especially when I finally went down and went through it, because at first I didn't know what it was all about, but the whole thing with Agency, with Franklin, the whole contract mission with Dre, those were really fun missions. And even now, especially doing the payphone hits are fun. Did I say fun? I meant fun. Always tongue-tied. Just somebody you just can't damage your car. Uh-oh. Yep. Now we got player is gonna probably grief because, yeah. If you're gonna grief in a low level lobby, yeah, because you want it all to yourself. Sometimes you actually fear other oppressors. Hell, some people are just intimidated, especially if you got a higher level like me. Because some people, I don't know, understand why they just want to blow other oppressors up. Because yeah, I'm the only, because if you say, I'm the only one who must have an oppressor. I must destroy you, because I'm just so intimidated. And even then, hell, there was one dude who was picking on another guy. One reason, because he had a bad mic. The other was because, yeah, this dude was like a low level, and he was like, and the other person he was picking on was like 150, and he was like a level 49. Yeah, big. Dude must think he's a big man. But yet again, since I was in that lobby the whole time, somebody was blowing him up with an oppressor earlier. And I was listening, and I was actually hearing the whole conversation. Usually, I don't have my mic on whenever I'm playing in GTA Online. And again, it's just like you want to. Again, it just shows that sometimes kids nowadays want to talk like they're big and bad, and they want to talk like they're smart. It's just kind of ironic though, but. A good thing is, at least it was a good thing. I felt good that I stuck up for the dude he was picking on. Because sometimes, guess what? Sometimes people can't really afford this. Sometimes you got to work with what you got. Sure, especially the mic I'm using right now. It's a little on the lower end, but at least it's a little better than the HyperX headset I was using, and definitely way better than the Turtle Beach one I had a long time ago. Where is this? Okay, here it is. But that's the whole thing, though. Most of the people in the some people who are in the GTA community, at least a good chunk of them, are pretty toxic-ass people. But, again, you either ignore them or mute them. Of course, some of them are just squeaker little kids who obviously are way too young to be playing this game, because I don't condone selling extremely violent games or even parents advise kids not to buy this game. Seriously, if you're a parent who buys your kid like a violent video game like GTA, no. Give them games like Minecraft. It's a lot better. It's fun, and there's fun, and at least there's not as much toxicity in those games. Hell, even Terraria sounds like a much better game. But no, I think parents just give their kids these games because, of course, it's just like they probably won't be cool in school if they don't have this game, or they just get it for them and use it as a way to babysit them for a few hours. I know. Oh, this is big and bold of you, Jet Sparks, to be saying this, because you even have kids? No, I don't. But I can see the problems of where things are going with how parents deal with their kids.
Boorsville,
really? Is there anything I will justify killing? It's the NPCs.
All right, well, the buyer's got the product, and you got the profits. Looks like a successful transaction to me.
After you.
Oh, midnight session in the morning. Shoot. I forgot about them being online.
Exactly.
Anything to be going live with this Memorial Day. That trial. I think there was no doubt. I mean, come on, we all know. I mean, seriously, how insane? You not know a woman is completely insane if she drops a deuce on a bed. You know that. Like, come on.
Thank you.
Shit. Oi. Oi, guy. Oh god, take the pole with me. Take the pole. Oh, there it goes. Huh. Oh. Those Faith Clan douchebags. Motherfuckers never give up, do they? Lord, you know these guys? Jesus. Okay, that was awesome.
Nice work. Your technicians are already breaking that down.
Oh, the zombie's starting to fill up now. Oh boy.
In case you were worried about selling these arms and them not getting used, we got a buyer airlifting this shipment right into a hot zone. You'll need big off-roaders to get to the pickup sites, so get in the cab and get on the road.
America. Happy Memorial Day. In defense of all those, so I could have the freedom to do this stupid shit. Push comes to shove. That's the reason why when things really go to hell, we must fight tooth and nail to keep our nation safe. And that is the whole point of this glorious movie here. That point, so I'll probably watch a little bit later. Once again, sorry. I'm sniffling right now. They say the Mass Effect Mako controls worse. Oh shit. Marshall's still okay, and we got more of them. Yay. Fuck.
Fuck you, Benzie!
Oh no. There we go. That's all of
I'd be happy to help you before finishing my shift.
Oh. Alright, full of snacks, but good day, sir. Let's see if I can just grab that bounty. Because why not? egg.
Look at that. All deliveries received. Now let's just hope they know.
Alright, yeah. Probably not that bounty's really nothing, but hey, better get her to get it off the person rather than just someone else grab it. I get close enough to try to drop it on him. Okay, the hell with it. Fuck. Oh, shit.
Total buzzkill.
Got him. Yes, nobody wanted to go for it. Sorry.
What's up, boss? I'll be here.
Excuse me. I'll just do one mission and I'll end the stream after this. I think I'm getting the same missions over and over again. Asset protection or whatever. I think out of all of them, I really don't like. I don't like the asset protection at all.
Look, so our client is the CEO of a fancy ass perfume brand.
Yep. This one again. Yep. And I'm right in the middle of a gang war. Yay. Safe is. I know, anyone who's British, again, I can't even say it. Us Americans sound literally sound like twats whenever we Americans say it. It just sounds weird. See? Even me saying it just now, saying British idioms sound weird. Huh. It came out to life pretty quickly. Oh boy. There's an oppressor out there. Oh boy. Oh, goody. Fuck. Fuck. Oof, made it. Intense.
Get over the Character's all tore up.
Hey, you did good.
But that's about it. Well, this is going up on YouTube later on, so till next time, everyone. And may God and the Force be with you.